Hello students, next we will look into the properties of Laplace transform. Based on your syllabus, what is written is that we have to introduce the properties of Laplace transform and not concentrate too much on the proofs. But generally, up till now, wherever you go, proofs of these properties are generally always asked. So what I want you to note now is that we may have to study the proofs. We may have to study the proofs of these properties later. Once we get to know if these portions are important, to get to know if the proofs will be asked in the exam. So since it is, as of now, the information that I have got is that it will not be asked in the examination and only the result of the properties of Laplace transform will be asked. So basically I am going to skip the proofs for now. But based on this, whatever is the result and whatever is the, what do you say, problems that we may get after it, that we will surely study. Okay, so let us do it. The first proof that we have to study is linearity property. Linearity property. The first property that we have to study is the linearity property. What is linearity property? The linearity property helps us to find the Laplace transform of two functions when they are added up. Okay. The property basically is if there is a function f of t whose Laplace, f1 of t whose Laplace is f1 of s, and there is another f of t which is f2 of t, let us name it as f2 of t, whose Laplace transform is f2 of s. Okay, see, I have written capital F, okay, capital F1 of s and capital F2 of s. Then according to linearity property, the Laplace transform of the linear combination of f1 and f2. So what is a linear combination means? There is some constant a1 into f1 of t plus a2, another constant f2 of t, is going to be the Laplace transform of this function is going to be a1 f1 of s plus a2 f2 of s. Okay, this is something that is very important to understand because this is one of the basic properties. Okay, this is one of the basic properties. So if we are having a function, okay, f1 of t and f2 of t. See, I have not written a1 as a1 of t. No, I have not written it like this. I have written a1 only because it is not dependent on time. That means it is constant. Constant, that means it is not dependent on time. It is not dependent on time. That means it is not dependent on t. So it is not a function of t, it is some constant. Only in the case of constant you can do. Okay, you must not, many people make this mistake initially. They think that f1 of t multiplied with, f1 of t multiplied with f2 of t is going to be equal to f1 of s multiplied with f2 of s. No, This is totally wrong. It is never correct. This is something that most of the people make mistake initially. They will think that okay, here multiplication is okay between A2 F2 and A1 F1. So here I have written A1 into F1s and A2 into F1s. No, A1 is a constant. It is not a function of time. So if you have A1 of t multiplied with F1 of t, then its Laplace transform is not A1 of s into F1 of s. No, that is totally wrong. It is wrong. So if you are having multiplication, you can't do that. So this is not multiplication property. It is basically the linearity property. And in linearity property, the one that you are multiplying here, that is basically a constant. It is not a time-based function. See, if you are having a time-based function like a1 of t, then the Laplace of transform of that will be capital A1 of s. Okay, but here that is not the case. Here it's a constant. That's why here also, this side also, we are writing it as a1 and a2. Okay, now we can study the proof of that, but as of now there is no proof, I am assuming. So what we will do is we will basically look at some of the example. We have to find the Laplace transform of sine omega t. Okay, suppose we want to find the Laplace transform of sine omega t. Okay, so we know that sine omega t can be written as e raised to power j omega t minus e raised to power minus j omega t divided by j omega. This is basically called as Euler's relation. Here we pronounce it as Euler's relation, but it is originally pronounced as Euler's relation. Okay, so this equation is pretty well known. Okay, so based on this, we can now write that you are having, therefore if we say that, let me write it here, therefore if we say that we want to take the Laplace transform of sine omega t, we want to find out the Laplace transform of sine omega t, it is as good as finding the Laplace transform of, see now how I am going to write it, j omega is going to be common for both, so I will write 1 by j omega into e raised to power j omega t minus again 1 by j omega e raised to power minus j omega t. See, generally what is the format here, I have written, see, a1 into f1 of t. So here I am having this as a1. Now why I have written this as a1? Because 1 by j omega has no time component, there is no t, isn't it? So I can very easily say that this is a1, but this is a function of time, e raised to power j omega t. So I can write it as f1 of t, correct? Also remember that e raised to power j omega t can be imagined as e raised to power at. Okay, e raised to power at. So I can, in a way I can imagine it like this. Okay, similarly this one can be imagined as a2 and this one can be imagined as f2 of t, which is basically e raised to power minus at. Okay, we already know what is the Laplace transform of e raised to power at u of t. Okay, so generally I should have written sine omega t u of t, but generally they omit that part out. So from now onwards, I'm not going to write this. You can basically remember this. Okay. So now, since this has come in this format, now I will write that this can be written as, you can directly write the result, or I will write this as separate one. Okay. this I can write it as, I can find out that this is the Laplace transform of 1 by j omega e raised to power j omega t minus Laplace transform of 1 by j omega e raised to power minus j omega t. Okay, and if you are going to take the Laplace transform of each of this, you will get, okay, you will get the answer. So see, whenever there is a constant to be multiplied, that we can basically take out. Okay, we know, I will straight away write, we know that Laplace of e raised to power j omega t is similar to e raised to power 8t, which I can write 1 divided by, what is the property? See, what is the property we have previously seen? That it is e raised to power minus 8t u of t, isn't it? So if I am writing e raised to power 8t u of t, then that Laplace transform will be 1 divided by s. Now instead of a, I am having the opposite sign of it, so it is s divided by s minus a. So it's better that you write this one. Where did we write? Yeah, this one you can write it as, if it is minus, it is plus. If it is plus, it is going to be minus. Okay, so for plus, it is minus, and for minus, it is plus. That if you remember, then we can basically use that here. So this one will become s raised to power s minus j omega, and Laplace of e raised to power minus j omega t is going to be 1 divided by s plus j omega. Okay, therefore we can say that Laplace of sine omega t, now I am going to use here, therefore using which property? Using the linearity property. Using the linearity property, what do I write? I can straight away write this portion. Something has happened here, just hold on. So using the linearity property, I can basically write that this will be 1 by j omega multiplied with the Laplace transform, this one. So it is 1 by s minus j omega minus 1 by j omega with 1 by s plus j omega. So what I have used this property, see. If I am multiplying a1 with f1 of t, then I will have to multiply a1 with f1 of s. Here it is plus, even if it is not plus, if it is minus, then here also it will be minus. That's all. So here, instead of a1, what we have? Here we have this one. So that is multiplied with the Laplace transform of this one. What is the Laplace transform of that? It is this one. Correct? Similarly, minus this one multiplied with the Laplace transform of that which is given by s. Okay, let me rub all these unnecessary markers. So based on that, we have got this. I can combine it together. I can write 1 by j omega as common, and this I can get it as, you know, if you do the subtraction, I will get s plus j omega minus of s minus j omega divided by s minus j omega multiplied with s plus j omega. This is similar to x minus y into x plus y. What is x minus y into x plus y? x square minus y square, correct? So I will use that. I will again write, therefore Laplace transform of sine omega t is going to be equal to 1 by j omega And here, now this s and this minus s will cancel off, whereas these two will get added up. J omega and minus of minus j omega is again plus. So I will get 2 times j omega, and here I will have s square. Okay, I will have s square. Let me see if I have missed anything. I think I missed something here. Yeah, this is not going to be j omega, sorry. The Euler's relation says that this is going to be j2. Oh, I made a big mistake. So this is going to be 2j, sorry. So based on that, I have to write this one again as 2j. All of this has to change, sorry. Okay, so the change is basically this is 1 by 2j, this is 1 by 2j, this is again 2j, 2j, this becomes again 2j, 2j, and this one again becomes 2j. Okay, and then we have 2 times j omega divided by s square minus j omega square. Okay, now tell me what is j square, or what is j omega the whole square is basically j square into omega square. Now what is j square? J square is, what is j? J is under root of minus 1, correct? So j square will be minus 1. J square will be minus 1. So here I will have minus of omega square. So here if I am going to substitute that, see 2j and this 2j will cancel off. So in the numerator I will have only omega divided by s square, and this minus of this one, j omega square, will become minus omega square. So I will get this as plus omega square. And that is going to be the Laplace transform. So let me write that properly now. So what I should write is, therefore, sine omega t is basically Laplace transform is given by omega divided by s square plus omega square. Okay, so let me put that in a box. And this I will write it here, so the sixth result that I am having is that if I am having sine omega t, I should write u of t, but I am omitting that for the time being, then I should get this as the Laplace transform will be omega divided by s square plus omega square, s square plus omega square. Okay, so that is the answer. What I will do is I will rewrite and write this thing little, looking little bit crowded, so I will avoid the clutter. So I have written this with little bit apart so that it is not very confusing now. Okay, so this is one of the results. Similarly, if you would try to find out for the case of cos, so I will write that also, that if you would try to find out for the case of cos omega t, you will get the answer as s divided by s square plus omega square. That I will give you as one of the assignments or worksheet. You have to do it on your own. Okay, so for doing that, what you should remember is, basically is that here for the case of sine it was given like this. If it was cos, cos omega t according to Euler's relation, I will write it somewhere in the next page, okay? For cos omega t, according to Euler's relation, I can write it as e raised to power j omega t plus e raised to power minus j omega t divided by 2. So use the same principle that you have used previously in the previous example, okay, and you will be able to find out that the Laplace transform of this is going to be of cos omega t, u of t I am not going to write, is basically Laplace transform, it is going to be equal to s divided by s square plus omega square. Okay, you follow the same method that we have previously followed and you will get the same answer. Okay, so next let us go to the next property. The next property is scaling property. Okay, so the second property is scaling property. Okay, what is the scaling property says? The scaling property says that if the Laplace transform of f of t is capital F of S, then for a constant A, the Laplace transform of F A into T will be given by 1 by A f of s by a. That means what? That means that whatever is the value of a that you are having, okay, if you know this Laplace transform, then all you have to do is, if that there is a value a which is multiplied with t, then all you have to do in the other side is you have to multiply it with 1 by a, and wherever you see s, you replace it by s by a. That's all. Okay. So it's a very simple property. The proof, again, as I said, I will not take it now. Until I am very sure that it is going to come in your exam, I will not take it now. So where is its application? For example, now we have already studied what is sin omega t. So let me say, as an example, okay, so let me write this. Okay, example is find Laplace transform of sine a omega t. So see, generally whatever is written here you have to write, but suppose right now I have just multiplied omega t with a, okay, so I already know, so I will write solution. We know that the Laplace transform of sine omega t, the Laplace transform is given by omega divided by s square plus omega square, correct? Therefore, based on scaling property, what we are having is, suppose if I am having to find the Laplace transform of A omega t. See, now A is multiplied with this t function. So what we have to do? We have to first multiply it with 1 by A, and then wherever we are having S, so this is omega, there is no s, omega square also no s, but here we are having s, so that I will write it as s by a the whole square. See, I have replaced s with s by a, so s square will become s by a the whole square. Okay, so which I can now further say that this is a 1 by a, omega is there, divided by a square by a square. That a square, if I am going to multiply, I will get it multiplied with a square omega square, and here I am going to get a square. Correct? Why? Because s by a square by a square plus omega square is, first I have to take the denominator common, so it becomes a square plus, so multiplying and dividing, isn't it? So a square omega square. Correct? That same thing would come here, that a square, since it's in the denominator, that will go up in the numerator. Correct? That is what we have done here. So this is what we are having. So based on that, now this a and this a can cancel. One a can cancel. Okay. So we are having omega a by a square plus a omega square. So I can basically write, so let me write it. Therefore, sine a omega t, the Laplace transform is going to be omega a divided by s square plus omega a the whole square. Okay. So like that, we can do many problems. Now suppose if I am going to ask you, what is, okay, now let us do some problems based on it. Okay, some numericals. Find the Laplace transform of, okay, let's say a, f of t is equal to e raised to power minus a t phi e raised to power minus a t plus 3 sine 4 t. Okay, we have to find out the Laplace transform of this one. So how will we do? Okay, we know now this, instead of a, let me write this as 2. Okay, let me write this as minus of 2t. Okay, so we know that e raised to power minus 2t, the Laplace transform is going to be, so here instead of a, what I am having? 2. So the Laplace transform will be 1 divided by s plus a. Here a is 2, so I will write this. So we know this, and we also know that Laplace transform of sine 4t is basically omega. What is omega now here? Omega is 4 here, correct? So omega is 4 here. So I will write, instead of omega, I will write omega 4. So I will write 4 divided by s square plus 4 square. 4 square is 16. Okay, so this much I know. Then I will write, then using linearity property, I will get the Laplace transform of 5 e raised to power minus 2t plus 3 sine 4t. It is just like, a1 f1 of t plus a2 f2 of t, isn't it? See, a1 is the constant here, and here 3 is the constant for a2, isn't it? So what does linearity property says? Linearity property says that you multiply 5 with the Laplace transform of this. What is the Laplace transform of that? Into 1 divided by s plus 2. So I will just write 5 divided by s plus 2 plus 3 times 4 divided by s square plus 16, which is basically 4 into 3 is 12. So I will basically write 4 into 3 as 12. Okay, you can directly write it as 4 into 3 is 12. So that is the simple Laplace transform, okay, of a complex function. Clear? Or let's say we are going to take another one, which is b, Let's say if ft, now I'm going to use the principle of scaling here. So suppose I'm going to write f of t is going to be equal to 9 t square, and then I am having plus 4 cos t. Okay, now see, I can do this 9 t square, I can do it in two methods. Okay, I will just show. One is, we know that Laplace transform of t square is 1 by, how do we find out? We know that Laplace transform of t raised to power n is given by n factorial divided by s raised to n plus 1, correct? So t square will become 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial divided by s raised to power 2 plus 1 is 3. What is 2 factorial? 1 into 2, which is 2. 2 divided by s cube. This is one way of finding it. Okay. Or we can take this combined. Okay. That means 9 t square can be imagined as 3 t the whole square. Okay. 3 t the whole square. Now we already know. Okay. We already know t square is basically this. Therefore, we know t square is this. Therefore, one of the ways that we have to find out is, so 9 t square. So let me write here. Therefore, 9 t square can also be written as 9 times. Okay, 9 times. Then we are having t square, already we have the t square as 2 into s cube, which will be written as 18 by s square. Okay, so what I have done here, I have basically used this particular formula. From here to here, I use again the linearity property where I have just multiplied a constant, and constant as such gets multiplied, isn't it? Or if I am going to move through this method, I can also, you know, do using this method, but since this is much easier, so I will basically follow that. I don't want to confuse you anymore, so let us leave that one. Then similarly, in the other side, I am having 4 cos omega, so I can say cos t means cos 1t, okay, instead of omega being any value, it is omega is equal to 1 here. So that Laplace transform we have already seen, it is s divided by s square plus omega square. Omega here is 1, so it is going to be s square plus 1. Therefore, 4 times cos t is going to be 4s divided by s square plus 1. Therefore, I can combine together both of this. Therefore, 9 t square plus 4 cos t is basically written as 18 by s square plus 4s divided by s square plus 1. Now we can, you know, further solve it, but there is no need to do it. We can leave as such this one. Okay. So this is how we use properties. Now I have left this one to write the properties. The first property that we have to write here is the linearity property, and the second property that we will write is the scaling, time scaling property, or scaling property. And what is the property? What is the property for the case of linearity property? It is that a1 f1 of t plus a2 f2 of t, the Laplace transform will be a1 f1 of s plus a2 f2 of s. what scaling property says is that if you are having a function f of t, then the Laplace of f a t is going to be 1 by a f of, wherever you have s, replace it with s by a. Okay, so like that you have to maintain two pages. One page is basically for writing the individual results, and the second page is for writing the properties, because these properties you will again and again use. Okay, thank you.